Okay, so today we are going to see how to access the University of Arizona high performance computers. So you have two main clusters, one is the Ocelot and the other one is Elgato. So here the HPC, the Confluence, the document, it gives a good amount of resources on how to do it by yourself. So however, I'm just creating this short video to give a kind of start. So in this page you have the overview and the features of these clusters, so you can find that. And then they say that in Elgato you have the CentOS 7 and in the Ocelot you have CentOS 6. So those are the two clusters that you may run your work. So to get the access, so you need a bastion host for the access to all clusters. So since I'm using a Windows environment, so I may use the PuTTY. So I don't know how the for the Mac or Linux users. So first I would take the PuTTY environment, and then I have this my NetID and at hpcarizona.edu. So once you click on that, so it asks for your password. So that should be the password you use to log into your emails. And then there are you have to, there's a two-factor login for authentication. So you could use either a DuoPush if you have installed DuoPush in your mobile. So you could use DuoPush, or you could get a phone call or passcode. So I would take the first option. So I would type 1 and enter. And then I may get a login request in my mobile, so I'm going to accept it. And once I approved, yeah, so it's, this is a good thing. So this is kind of, you say, a gatekeeper. Here we cannot run anything. So this is kind of a place where you are directed to either the Ocelot or Elgato. So you have to here choose in which environment you're going to work on. So for now I'm going to work on Ocelot because I want to run some AMD simulations. So it is in Ocelot you have all the most of the common softwares installed. So you just have to type whatever the cluster you want and hit enter. So now you see that my name is changed, so the NetID and login too. So now I can browse to my files where I have created my files, everything. So it should be in this folder, so I'm in. And now once you're there, so this is what here it says, all you have everything here. And then you have something when you're running a job. So to run a job, you need to have a script. So they're using PBS. So you can read everything here, all the things in this page, how to run a job. So we can go to the next page clicking here. So here you have all the information you can read to get more information about like this, what is the script and everything about. So I have my script which I have created to run NAMD work. So we can see, so I took this script and modified according to my work. So you could try to do for yourself. So I have it in my folder. So this is my, you could open it using, so this is kind of, it is not so clear, but we can do easier. It's better to open it in Notepad or a text editor. You have, okay. So here, this is the kind of the whole script. Here you have, you can put what is your job name, and then what is the name, and then the group. So here you have to make sure you put which PI that gonna sponsor your work. And then here these two things is to get your email notification once your job is submitted and once your job has been completed. So you can get an email notification. So you have to make sure you put the NetID. And here like it is standard or binfold. Those are the two things you can get. And here, so if you have three comments, that means this line is kind of like you basically deleted, or this is not gonna read it along. So whatever with one hashtag, so it's gonna be read it out. So these are the specifications I'm going to run, and the wall time, how much time you want to run for this. And then I need to run namd, so I have written module load namd CUDA. And then this is the path where you can get this submission file and all my configuration files. So I have put it here. So, and then this should be the log file. So this is kind of the submission script that I would use. Okay, so once you save the script, so this is the folder I'm going to write. So I have my configuration file for the namd and the related parameter files and the PDB and the PSF and the fixed PDB. So this is my submission script. So in the PuTTY window, I'm going to call it. So if you want to submit, you have to say qsub submit, and then you call for the PBS script. So submission.pbs, that's the name I have given for this file, and hit enter. So if it's success, so you will be getting something like this. So it means this is the number of the job number, and it's running in the cluster. So you can refresh in the WinSP window and see whether any files has been created. So we see that a log file has been created. So it's been written, and with the time it's gonna create all the other files as well.